Hello, I'm Brian Walker with Copper Mountain Technologies. Today I want to show how to make phase measurements on a pair of cables from one end. Very often the other end of the cable is inaccessible. It might be at the top of a tower, and you still want to be able to measure the phase length through that cable and perhaps compare it to another cable. So we're going to do that. I have two cables here which are fairly long, and on the bench here I have an S5065 compact VNA. That's a 6.5 gigahertz VNA, and it'll do just fine for this measurement today. So I'll start with this. I'm going to call this my reference cable, and I'm going to compare the phase of this to the other cable on the bench. So I'll attach to port one, torque it with my calibrated fingers, and I'm going to switch to phase. Now here's how you would normally see the phase, wrapping plus or minus 180. For our purposes today, I'd rather it didn't do that because I want to normalize this. It will actually normalize in this fashion, but I'd rather not. There's no reason for it. Let's use the extended phase, which starts at zero, or expanded phase, and just goes negative forever. Now that I'm displaying that, I can go to display, memory, normalize. So now I'm measuring 0.07. Now, and it's changing. And it's changing because, in very tenths of degrees, because the temperature of the room is probably changing. I'm moving the cable. You know, all these things can make very small differences. 1 degree is about 7/1000ths of an inch distance change, or probably a little bend or something could also get there. One more thing, I just normalized with this cable open. If I have the opportunity, it's probably best to normalize it with a short. The reason for that is that with a short in place, I'm not going to have a problem if the pin lengths are different from one cable to another, because the pin is buried in the female connector of the calibration piece. Now I have this normalized and I'm getting a little drift, which I'd expect because I'm still moving the cable around a little bit. So keep in mind, the cable has to be very stable. So I'll normalize again. We'll just leave it there. Now, let's quickly go to the other cable. So this will be the cable I'm going to compare to my reference cable. Now the VNA is quite accurate, but you know, you do have to keep in mind that as soon as I move the cable around a little bit, things are going to change. Now, if this were a very expensive heliax cable on a tower, we probably wouldn't have to worry about that. I'm getting little ripples in the measurement, and that's due to the directivity of the VNA. I can take care of that. I know that the phase is flat, so I'll just smooth it a little bit. And now I can see that the phase difference between my reference cable and this cable is about 2.1. You know, average that a little. So it's about 2.18. Now, this is an S11 phase, so that's the phase going there and back. So the actual difference between these two cables is about 1.13 degrees now. So I've measured the phase difference between these two cables. Now, if I'd been trying to produce a pair of matched cables and I had a connector on one end, and I have a reference phase that I want to hit, I could have an open end of the cable here, and I could be measuring this normalized phase, and I could slowly clip away the end of the open end of the cable until I reach the phase that I'm after, and then install the connector. So it's very easy to create matched cables this way. Using the S11 method, it allows me to actually trim a cable to phase. So I hope that was clear, and thanks for listening. You can get more information about our products, of course, at www.coppermountaintech.com. Thank you very much.